Hey folks, Dagan here from PMTVUK, and today I'm here to share with you 10 habits that if you keep up, will make you a better guitar player. Now there are so many tips, tricks, and technique videos up here on YouTube for electric guitar players that it can be a bit intimidating when it comes to a quick little YouTube search when you want to jam some guitar. What should you learn? What shouldn't you learn? What's formal? What's informal? I mean, shoot, we've done loads of videos here at PMTVUK where we try to have a little bit of fun with it, like 6 crazy techniques for you to learn, 6 weird noises to make on your electric guitar. I'll link them all in the description box down below. But for now, I'm going to get quite serious and talk about 10 habits that I think you should pick up if you want to improve your guitar playing. Kind of the things that I wish I picked up when I was learning, because I would be much better than I am now if I'd learned these habits. And I'm well aware there's more than 10. So if you want to comment down below any habits you think up-and-coming guitar player should pick up, comment them down below and share the love, because I love learning just as much as you folk. And just before we get started, this rig sounds bloody amazing, doesn't it? I'm using my Kramer Pacer through 2 Attack cables into a Marshall 1987X. I'm hearing through a Marshall 1960 AV cab, but I actually have a 2-note Torpedo Captor X, which has a Marshall cabinet. I'm using it to attenuate the amp as well, so it's not blowing the windows out. So it sounds great. And all these lovely goodies are available at pmtonline.co.uk and linked in the description box down below. Anyways, let's get down to the cool habits you should have, all the habits you should have to make you a better guitar player. And the first one is very personal to me because it's my job, it's what you're watching right now. And the first habit I want you to get into is to record yourself playing guitar. Obviously, not doing that thing. Now I want you to do this whether you're just starting playing guitar, or you're an intermediate guitar player, or you're quite a seasoned guitar player. It's not a bad thing recording yourself, because then you can actually track your progress. And I don't just mean audio-wise, don't just like get a DAW and record into GarageBand or whatever you want to record into on a laptop. Phones are awesome these days. You can use the great camera on your phone, get a little tripod. Roland make little mixers, go mixers for your phone so you can plug your guitar in and have all the fun in the world, that kind of thing. The Boss GT1 amp thing does it as well. And record your progress. Because even me doing these videos, if I watch my videos from a few years ago, I can see where I've improved. And if I cared about that more at the time, I would have improved a lot quicker. So if you record yourself playing certain things, not every day, say every week or every fortnight in between practicing and stuff, you can go back and watch your improvement, or even watch yourself and go, that wasn't quite right what I did there. I'm going to practice that different next time. Because when you're playing, you're focusing too much on what you're actually doing. And when you watch it back, you can really kind of dissect it and learn from it, which is the point. Now, you haven't got to record full-on songs for YouTubers if you're going to upload them like covers and stuff. Or even scales. Just do what you want. Just play the stuff that you practice and see how you improve. Whether you want to sit there and be like, or so whatever you want, just record yourself doing it and then look back. And I wish I had recordings of me when I first started out. So when you record yourself and you evidently get super famous and end up playing Wembley Stadium, you're gonna look back at these videos and be like, ah, Jessica, look how good you've gotten since this first recording. I am Jessica, by the way. Look how good you've gotten since your first recording. So yeah, record yourself and keep, even just upload them to Dropbox or something. Just keep the history of your practice until you get super famous. And it'll be fun to look back on as well as learn from, which is the whole point of this habit. Next up, we have a habit which is more like, don't get in the habit of gripping your guitar neck too tight. Beginners all around the world grip their guitar neck too tight, and it's really hard on your fingers because your fingers aren't strong yet. So in order to get the chords and stuff down, you have to grip really tight. In some cases you have to do this, obviously, I know, but really focus on not putting too much strain on your hand, because it can hurt your wrists and stuff. Your fingers, your calluses get sore anyways on your fingers. The last thing you need is getting a sore wrist when you play guitar. So just focus on not getting in the habit of constantly gripping the neck too hard. Whether it means you have to move your thumb around, like classical playing, like put it all the way back here. Not using your thumb at all, which I've never even tried before. Yeah, don't do that, that hurts your fingers. But yeah, don't get in the habit of gripping your guitar neck too tight. The chords still ring out just the same, and if you are gripping your guitar neck too tight because you feel like the strings are too far away from the fretboard, go to your local PMT store if you bought it from PMT and get the guitar set up and make sure the action is okay. So the action is the distance between the strings and the fingerboard. It's called the action. And when it's nice and low, obviously it's easier to press down when it's not so low. It's harder, therefore harder on your wrists and fingers. Next up, I want you to get in the habit of playing guitar songs out your comfort zone, because it will improve your guitar playing. Just straight up it will. Like, I'm a 80s rock guy, I love 80s rock. But I played that for so damn long that I was like, I kind of don't really know anything else. So I broadened my horizons, started listening to jazzy stuff. Do I listen to jazz in the car? No. Do I want to play jazz live on stage? No. But when you make your fingers work a certain way and playing guitar, these chords that you never played before, it's really satisfying to do. So fun to do as a guitar player, playing these beautiful chords and stuff. Is it the music that got me into guitar playing? No. What I listen to is any other time than learning it? No. But it improved my guitar playing, and it makes it sound like you know what you're doing, which is kind of every guitar player's dream, to make it look like they know what they're doing. So if you know a few jazzy things, or if you know a few like bluesy licks, if you're a thrash metal guy, or even pop songs, there's some great guitar stuff and pop songs. I'm now evidently a huge Taylor Swift fan, because some of Taylor Swift's guitar stuff is just absolutely phenomenal. Paul Stiotti, her guitar player, plays EVH Wolfgangs and stuff, so he's a proper metal dude at heart. But there's some great guitar playing on some of that stuff, and just kind of play out of your comfort zone. The caveat to this is don't play stuff that you don't enjoy. Obviously, if you don't enjoy jazz and stuff, power through for that kind of thing. But a lot of guitar teachers, I found when I was starting, make you play things that you don't really enjoy, like Mary Had a Little Lamb and that kind of thing, which is fun for getting your finger up, and those are the kind of songs that everyone knows, but you have to remember to play the songs that you enjoy, because guitar playing is about having fun and enjoying yourself, but just get a bit jazzy sometimes because it's fun. Next up, let's get in the habit of practicing our vibrato and bending. Because when it comes to practicing, everyone just practices usual stuff, either practicing the songs you want to play, or jazz, if you want to do jazz, or scales and stuff. No guitar teacher just kind of says, right, practice this. They obviously do teach you how to bend, but people don't focus on it as much as they should, I don't think. Even myself, a few years ago, when I first met the legend that is Jared James Nichols, I was like, dude, your bending is crazy. Like, it's so good. He's like, that's because I sit and only practice bending. I sit for an hour and a half when I'm watching TV or whatever, and I just practice bending. So I'm like, what? So you don't even practice, like, you don't jam or anything or do anything, any scales? He's like, no, I just practice bending. Pick one note. Pick the note you want to bend to. Either keep it there. Just pick that note, or whatever note you want. Whatever note you want to bend it. Don't be too daft. Don't be like, pick the note. And try and get it nailed on, okay? And once you're there, either at the top of the note, practice controlling your vibrato, because vibrato is well and good doing it like on a single string where you're not bending. It sounds great, doesn't it? Don't be too erratic and don't press down too hard. Again, people get in the habit of pressing down too hard while doing chords and stuff. Also when doing vibrato, you get that crazy kind of that kind of stuff, which sounds good when Angus Young does it, but that's deliberate. Don't do that. Work on a nice smooth and work with the wavelength of the tone. That's only one part. So when you get to that note that you're trying to hit, okay? Then work on your vibrato at the top of the bends. It sucks to do, but when you get it right, just the practice makes perfect. And granted, I could even improve my bends, because Jared is an absolute beast. But when I found out that he only sits and only practice bends, that made me sit and practice bends, and I realized that I need to sit and practice my bends. So get in the habit of not just practicing songs and scales and stuff, but practice those bends and that vibrato. Next up, the last really, really obvious one that I always say in tip videos and stuff, I want to drill it home into your heads. The habit of playing to a metronome. Because the amount of guitar players that can really show off and do crazy stuff and show off to all their friends, and it's great. As soon as you put them to a metronome or try and get them to play along with the band, it's like, dude's got no timing. Or Dudette has no timing. So even on your phone, you haven't got to get one of the old school like TikTok metronomes and stuff. I use the app, which is called Metro Timer, and it's great. And you can do whatever you want with that. You can practice single note stuff, practice chords, practice songs, get the BPM of a certain song you enjoy and try and play along with that song. But it's just crucial to get your timing right. I would say probably, yeah, just practice along with certain single notes, like I was just doing there. And speed it up, obviously. Practice that, but yeah, get in the habit of rehearsing, practicing with a metronome. You haven't always got to do it, but when you can, do. Don't be like, I'm not going to turn the metronome on. Always turn the metronome on, and you'll thank yourself in a few years' time. Promise. Next up, a one that I always see in guitar stores, people not doing. But you should get in the habit of changing your guitar strings. Because guitar strings get manky. And manky guitar strings are hard to play. Like, they feel all tight and taut and horrible, and when they're not stretched in right, and they get grimy, and they look gross, and they feel gross. Especially when you bring it into a music store and say, can you fix my guitar? And the guitar strings are gross. It costs nothing. You can't buy specialist guitar stuff, which does a great job of cleaning it, but even just get a damp cloth and clean your strings every now and then. But when they're dead, they're dead. And that might put you off guitar playing. Oh, my guitar doesn't stay in tune very well. It sounds a bit dead, it sounds a bit muffled, it sounds a bit drained of all of its energy. Could just be the strings are dead. Even if you don't play the guitar for an extended period of time and it's sat on your wall, it's sat in the case, it's sat in the corner of your living room collecting dust, the strings will just die. The metal, because it's under so much tension, will just kind of lose all of its life and stuff. So get in the habit of changing your strings. Not every week. You're not Slash. You're not playing in front of thousands of people for 4 hours every single night. But every month or so, every 2 weeks, depending on what you want to do with the guitar, you can buy fancier strings like Daddario NYXLs, which last a little bit longer. But still get in the habit of changing your strings if you're starting out more than you think you should. Because, oh, they're still there. They haven't snapped yet. I'll change them when they snap. No, it'll sound like bins. Change them to keep them alive and to make a guitar sound its best, because that'll make you want to pick it up more. Next up, similar to the metronome chat, get in the habit of playing with other people, because you can practice as much as you want to your scales and stuff and jam along with your favorite artists and that. Even jam along with a metronome. It's a totally different ballgame when you get to playing with other people. Bouncing off other people and trying to find out your space in the band. A little extra habit here. Get in the habit of playing to your surroundings. So if you're a big Metallica fan or something and you're in the local band which are playing pop songs, don't have a crazy tone. Work, like, get in the habit of adapting to your surroundings, because again, it'll improve you as a guitar player because you're out of your comfort zone. But yeah, get in the habit of playing with other people, whether it be at school, whether it be a local club, like here in Newcastle. I'm sure I've heard folks say there's a Shadows club, because Mark Knopfler's from Newcastle, and he's in Shadows. Is it Mark Knopfler? My brains went dead. What? No. Mark Knopfler's in Dire Straits, isn't he?
Yes.
Who's in the Shadows again? Hank Marvin from the Shadows. It's War Hank Marvin. He's not a Geordie. Is he a Geordie? No, he's not a Geordie. Anyways, there's a Shadows club where they all get together and just sit and jam songs and like bounce off each other. Or they don't like go through and play the solo. Just kind of enjoy the music and appreciate the guitar playing, but most importantly, play it together. And you might pick up tips and tricks from other musicians around you. Whether they not be guitarists themselves, you'll just be immersed in the world that is musicians. So yeah, get in the habit of jamming with other people. No matter what your age, what your skill level, you'll improve no matter what. This kind of moves on nicely to the next habit that you should have, and that is to get in the habit of playing other instruments. Now, not the triangle or the little cymbal things that you see folk use, but like bass playing. If you're a guitar player and you're improving and you want to kind of expand your knowledge of everything fretted instrument wise, get a bass. It hasn't got to be a good bass. Get a secondhand bass from eBay or something, or PMT, just some great new basses for like 99 quid, all the Encore stuff. I've got a bass and I love playing it, and I feel like my guitar playing has improved from playing bass. And the bass player in my band is an actual real life bass player, and he plays guitar because he wants to kind of learn how these chords work and adapt them together. So yeah, get in the habit of picking up other instruments. Bass isn't for you? Nothing wrong with learning drums. That'll certainly help with your timing when it comes along playing on metronomes and playing along with other people in your local vicinity. Don't necessarily treat it as you have to learn a whole other instrument. Just use it alongside your main instrument to expand everything and have a bit more fun and learn a bit deeper than what you would have done if you weren't playing this other instrument. Because we're all musicians after all. Second to last habit you should get into now, and this is for the rock and rollers and the metal fans out there, and that's to not play with too much distortion, especially when you're starting out, because distortion masks things. It sounds great when it's masked. It sounds like Metallica, and Metallica are awesome. But if you're sloppy with your chords and stuff, and things aren't going quite right, it's all kind of masked in that wall of saturation, that fizzy loveliness that we all adore so much. But you can use it to hide certain things. So when you're practicing, get in the habit of practicing with a cleaner tone to work on your mistakes, because they'll unfortunately jump out a lot more with a clean tone, but because of that, it means you can work on it and improve. So yeah, get in the habit of dialing that gain a little bit back, you metalers out there. And last but certainly not least, it's been a bumpy ride, but an awful lot of fun, hasn't it? Get in the habit of taking some time off and not taking yourself too seriously. You've got to remember to take some time off playing the guitar. If your fingers hurt and stuff, it's all well and good. I've read stuff online of working through the pain and working through the calluses and stuff. No, that'll suck the fun out of it. You've got to keep it fun and you've got to keep time off. Even if you're an established guitar player, like I'm going away for a couple of days next week. And I really want to take a guitar because I love playing guitar, but I'm deliberately not going to take one to give myself a break from the fretboard, from looking down and stuff. And when you come back to your instrument after you've been away for so long, it's, I don't know, you kind of enjoy it a lot more. You appreciate and love it as if it was, I don't know, as if you've never seen it before in your life. It's just a little thing like that which keeps it exciting as well. It's very fun to practice every single day, but if your fingers hurt or if you feel like you've, I don't know, got to where you want to be and it might be a bit of a chore, there's no shame in leaving the guitar for a week, 2 weeks, a weekend, whatever, and just, there's no shame in taking some time off. So get in the habit of giving yourself some time to rest mentally and physically from the fretboard, and then you'll enjoy it so much more when you go back. Mick Mars from Motley Crue, one of my favorite guitar players of all time, one of the reasons I play guitar, he's very ill. People might know about his back condition and stuff, and that didn't allow him to play guitar for like a year and a half, which sucked for him. And when he went back to it, he's like, I feel like I've never played it before. It feels like a whole new instrument. Obviously he knew what he was doing because he's bloody Mick Mars, but he was like, I have a whole new appreciation for this after a year and a half. That's a bit drastic and a bit intense. But yeah, give yourself a little time off from the guitar and you'd appreciate it so much more when you go back. Don't feel guilty about it. So there we have it, folks. The habits I think you should take on board if you want to improve your guitar playing. Whether you're just starting out or you're quite an established guitar player, just things to take on board to keep at the front of your mind, to keep things fresh and to keep things entertaining and to improve your guitar playing overall. And like I said at the start, please comment down below if you want to add anything or expand on anything that I've spoke about in this video. If you liked it as well, give it a thumbs up and subscribe to PMTVUK here on YouTube for lots more cool guitar and music related content. If you want any more information on any of the gear that I've talked about in this video, they're all linked in the description box down below, as well as those tips and tricks videos that I mentioned at the start as well. Or rock up to your local PMT store and try some out for yourself and get some tips and tricks from the guys and gals that work at PMT. We are PMT House of Rock on Facebook, Instagram and now TikTok. Give us a like and a follow to see pictures of these with nice filters on. I've been Dagan and I'll see you next time.